Hello, I'm John Bratton, and I'd like to take a few minutes of your time to tell you about work and organisational behaviour. As you know, there are many OB textbooks on the market, so why write this book? I wrote this book because I couldn't find a textbook that fitted the approach I wanted to take. I wanted an introductory book that draws from psychology and sociology, one that would be more critical in orientation, and one that would be accessible to management students. Writing this book has been a team effort. The other authors, Melissa Callanan, Carolyn Forshaw, and Peter Sochuk, are committed to providing a more critical explanation of organisational behaviour. So what is different about our book compared with alternative introductory textbooks? You'll find that our approach covers the familiar three levels of analysis: individual, group, and organisational. But we depart from mainstream OB textbooks in three important respects. First, we take the reader on an intellectual journey that draws on the psychology and the sociology of work. We have taken the view that sociological analysis strengthens OB studies. So we privilege the idea that history and the interplay of people and society matter. We use examples and case studies to emphasise that organisational behaviour is embedded in the particularities of time and society, and in the dynamics of the local and the global. For example, if you look at Chapter 8, you'll see that we suggest that work-related learning goes beyond notions of individual cognition to incorporate an awareness of context, communities of practice, power, and other social factors. Second, we frame the whole book around six core themes: competing standpoints, change in the workplace, the relationship between the self and the social, diversity, inequality, power, and globalization. These core themes illustrate the contested nature of organisational behaviour as a field of study. They also constitute and support what we understand as a critical approach. That is, these core themes encourage a pluralistic or multi-voice perspective on organisational behaviour. Third, we offer readers a global appreciation of workplace behaviour. This is achieved by bringing together a diverse selection of academic material and behaviour practices from Europe, North America, and parts of Asia. For example, we've cited OB practices from Canada, China, India, as well as the UK. We also included cases located in Finland, Norway, New Zealand, and the United States, which help to explore the notion that organisational behaviour is socially embedded. We remain sensitive to gender, language, and race issues throughout. In a world in which we are all expected to be sensitive to cultural diversity, our book offers students an accessible alternative to the more Anglo-centric, individualist-orientated books on the market. I hope you'll consider adopting Work and Organizational Behaviour for your course. Do take the time to explore the rest of their website, where you will find useful teaching resources as well as more detailed information about the book. Thank you for listening.